Welcome back. Police in Florida have released this surveillance video of a suspect who they say deliberately set fire to the mosque where the Pulse nightclub shooter once worshipped. The fire broke out early Monday morning at the Islamic Center of Fort Pierce. The extent of the damage still being determined, but no one was inside at the time, thankfully. Now police are hoping someone will recognize the suspect who local Muslims say committed a hate crime. We get more from CNN's Boris Sanchez.
Christine and George, officials don't have too many details as to the suspect's background right now. They're actually putting this video out there, hoping that someone in the public will recognize him and lead them to the suspect. What we know so far is that he's a Hispanic or white man, and he showed up here at the mosque at about 11:30 last night in a Harley Davidson-style motorcycle. He was wearing a bandana to cover his face, and he was wearing a hat, so it was difficult to really get detail of his face. He was wearing a button-down shirt and embroidered jeans, and he was carrying something that looked like a glass full of liquid and paper. At one point during the surveillance video that was captured, you see a white flash, and then you see that man flee. Officials have yet to publicly speculate whether or not this is a hate crime, but speaking to officials here at the mosque and local Muslim leaders, they tell us there is no doubt in their mind that this was a hate crime. And one of the people here at the mosque that I spoke with said that this is part of a trend, a continuing trend of escalating attacks against Muslims in this country. He says a big part of it has to do with the political climate.
We are in an electoral year when we have political candidates fueling the hate, fueling the divisions among Americans, and exalting anything that diminishes Islam or Muslims. That doesn't help, and that does create this kind of environment, unfortunately.
Another interesting note from Mr. Ruiz. He told me that if this had happened at a church on Christmas, the reaction would be much different. We've heard from local leaders here that they expected a much bigger public outcry from state and local government officials, one of them saying that the silence from them is deafening. Christine and George.
Boris Sanchez reporting. Boris, thank you.